Thanks, Stu. Well, as you just saw, the governor's address focusing almost entirely on the abuse of opiate drugs in the Green Mountain State. And that prompted no small number of questions from the Montpelier Press Corps about his plan to battle addiction and how that plan might be funded. WPTZ's Lauren Victory attended the governor's post-State of the State news conference and joins us now live in the newsroom with more. Lauren.
Yeah, Judge, reporters pressed the governor on his proposal to use $200,000 to expand staffing at local opiate addiction centers. When asked how many addicts that would help, Shumlin didn't have a specific answer. He did say that the quick shot of money will reduce the amount of people waiting for treatment. Shumlin says the centers have agreed to then budget themselves for that added staff in future years. Now, this overall opiate defeat plan draws several supporters, including Vermont mayors, state and local law enforcement leaders, and the CEO of the Rutland Regional Medical Center. But perhaps the most compelling and telling advocate, a recovering addict from Swanton. 25-year-old Justin Macy talked to the crowd about his struggle with pills and said the decision to get help doesn't come easy, and if it does, access to treatment needs to be immediate.
The people that can do it at home, great for them. I don't know too many people that actually have done it, but it's just good to get away, not have the same people you're hanging around and being in the same house that you used in, just getting away. For me was a huge thing, but without beds, it's hard to do that.
Now, the West Ridge Center for Addiction Recovery opened in Rutland in November to alleviate backlogged centers in Burlington and West Lebanon, New Hampshire. The governor says there are still waiting lists. Now, the recovering addict who spoke today also said the unavailability of beds could mean life or death for some addicts. Shumlin admitted he might not have the perfect solution, but that he looks forward to collaborating with legislators to find one this session. Live in the newsroom, I'm Lauren Victory, WPTZ News Channel 5.